adopt the updated Lowndes County Hazard Mitigation Plan, Mr. Tyler.
So every 5 years, we're required, every county in Georgia, every county in the country is required to update their hazard mitigation plan. So hazard mitigation plan kind of drives some of the things we do to prevent or limit the impact that disasters might have on our community. You know, we've had one since, I believe, our initial hazard mitigation plan was adopted in 2005. We've maintained every 5 year updates since then. Just like we did last time, we updated our current plan was adopted in 2017 and expires in February next year. Last time we used the regional commission to help facilitate the update process. And so that process involved meeting with a lot of our community stakeholders, our partner agencies. And so we go over and look. First step in the process was to figure out, do we have any new hazards that we need to add to our plan? So kind of do a hazard, what we're doing is assessment. We want to look and see what did we accomplish out of the old plan. So things that we can take out because we've accomplished them or they're no longer applicable. And then look and see what are some new things that we can do that might, we might implement over the next 5 years to help set, you know, make our community more resilient. Really, the most important reason that we do this is because this plan ensures that we remain eligible for disaster funding and federal funding through FEMA. So it is a requirement. But we had very good meetings. The process has taken a little over a year. I believe the chairman was at several of the meetings. Had good attendance and good input. Elizabeth back from the regional commissions here. Haven't had any questions for her, but we have gotten approval from FEMA and GEMA has approved our plan. So really it's just pending adoption by the board. And we'll be approved for another 5 years. And in a few years, we'll start process over again. But we were able to check off several things from the old plan. We've accomplished a lot, especially in the areas of flood mitigation, those things. So if you have any questions about the hazard mitigation plan update,